Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How are we getting on? Welcome to a brand new camp tour. And today we are having a look around my new castle camp that is inspired by the Blue Ridge build I did the other week. It sort of set this idea off. So let's have a look around. So, as I said, this is inspired by the Blue Ridge build I did the other week, and it sort of encouraged me to put together a kind of castle build using the Brotherhood of Steel pieces that we got in the previous season. But we're over in the Mire for this one, as you see, right by that lake there. So we're on the south edge, we're just north of Braxton's Quality Medical Supplies there, just a little bit over to the left. There's a little bay there that we're right at the head of. So you can sort of find the position there. There's a tiny little island sticks out from the shore. It's barely even an island, it's tiny, but that is the relevant place, and we'll talk about it in a second. Here is our little castle. So yeah, as I said, I used the Brotherhood stuff to make the main tower of the Blue Ridge build the other week, which I will link up in the corner for you. And looking at that, I thought it might be good for making it a kind of castle-type camp. So the basic floor plan of this is the center section is a 3x3 square of foundations, and then on each corner you've got three more foundations going around the corner in a right angle just to sort of make towers, which makes the shape a little bit more interesting, and it works. So I'm up here in the Mire because I wanted to build out over the water so that I could have a kind of drawbridge type vibe, or the closest we get. It's one of the rare occasions I find a use for the bridge pieces, which is a pity because they're cool pieces, they just don't go high enough to do what I'd like them to do. So just taking a quick look outside, I've got a single foundation with a load of corn in it and some fencing around it, which is just there for functional reasons. It's a little awkward to get the gate to close when you haven't got the HUD on, but there we go. So very, very simple, it's just so I've got a bit of food. Haven't got any water purifiers, anything like that, because we're right on the build budget with this one. I've managed to fill it up, but yeah, got everything I really need. Let's head over a bridge and into the front door. Tough to decide on a door for this. This particular doorway doesn't have a Brotherhood door that fits in it, which is weird, but ordinary ones do. So I've gone for this sort of security gate here. And we come straight into the ground floor, and we have our crafting room. So there's only two floors in this place, well, three if you count the roof, but I decided to keep it reasonably compact and small because otherwise, well, we ran out of room as it was, basically. So going too big would have been a problem. We'll have a little look in the first of the towers, and this main room is the central area, and we come through here and this sort of L-shaped area on the corner is the tower. It's the same one each corner. We've got our Jenny room here with a few little extra bits and pieces as well. So my original idea was to have all four towers have staircases going all the way up in them, but it turned out I needed some extra rooms for some extra stuff, bedroom and bathroom and stuff like that. So these front two towers are pulled out the staircases and replaced them with just rooms. So we've got, as I say, the generator room in there. And we'll come across the front here into the other one. This one I was struggling to figure out what to do with because it ended up kind of being a spare space. I don't quite want to call it a spare room, but I decided to make it into a medical facility and put Doc Solomon in here. And we've got my symptomatic tucked in the corner as well. The sort of stretcher there makes a functional bed for anybody who actually needs it, but there's also the main bed upstairs, which we'll get to in a bit. There's Doc Solomon. Having a little look around this room. Obviously, this is a big 3x3 square, this space. So, decorating it just meant that I wanted to pull stuff off the walls, try and use the space a bit, make it look a bit more interesting. So, we've got sort of little clusters around. All the chemistry and chemical stuff on this side here, and then all the weapons and armor stuff clustered together on the other side, with a few bits and pieces just added to decorate them up. Forgot to put stuff on the Nuki-Cola stand there. Whoops. A couple of little mannequins as well. So for the stairwells, we'll go up this one and come back down the other side. These I really kind of struggled to decorate because they're not really functional other than the stairwell. So put a couple of seating areas in, a little bit of storage in here just to dress it up a little bit. It's a nice little spot to sit down in that corner, actually. Although I had originally planned to shoot the intro down there, but the camera was not very cooperative with the staircase. But what can you do? So I've used the lightest shade of brick wallpaper inside to give it a kind of stone feeling of a castle. Pretty good to stick with the concrete we've got for the outside as well. And I like the windows for this because it can be that kind of arrow slit vibe because they're so narrow. So that's kind of what inspired this. And here we go, the main living room. This is combining obviously the kitchen, dining room and living spaces. We've got a limited number of rooms. I could have partitioned it off into other rooms, but I kind of like the open plan vibe on this one. Make do with the space available because it's a functional building first. Well, theoretically, castles are anyway. You see, we've got a decent sitting area there around the fireplace. the kids' table from the Thanksgiving set there. I didn't bother picking up the chairs, but I did grab the table because we've actually got a decorated table that way. Let's have a shufti in here. This is my bathroom, as per. Little light on the decoration in the bathroom, as limited resources available. But we've got a sink, we've got a bog, we've got a bath as well, so everything you really need. And somewhere to put your towels as well, although it's a bit far from the bath now, I think about it. Yeah, in other words, reasonably comfortable bathroom. I wanted to use some of the new floor pieces, so use these, or floor pieces I haven't used before, rather, so use those tiled ones in there. See, with the floors in here, I've mixed up the pattern a little bit, just to make it a bit more interesting, and I don't normally do that, but it works quite well here. Excuse the interruption there, fog crawler came to hassle me. Solomon will hold him off, and then I'll run and deal with him, but we'll move on and have a look through the bedroom now. So, bedroom come office space in here. Again, it's still in one of the towers, just over the Jenny room downstairs. Just squeeze everything in here. I said in a previous build, this Vault-Tec bed here, that looks like a double bed, actually takes up the same amount of space as a single, which is very practical from a building standpoint. It goes in much smaller gaps, so that's cool. Use the room dividers there, the screens. Quite like these things. There's a clean set available as well, but I thought the rusty ones would be a bit more appropriate. Struggled to decorate inside of them, but put the spinning wheel in there anyway. I do like this living space. It's kind of comfortable for castle living. Nice little fireplace, plenty of decorations on show. Yeah, looks all right. I really like the mixing up of the floor textures. Normally, I'm not in favour of that, but in this case, the big contrasts work quite well with the mosaic floors and then the regular sort of flagged floors with the pattern on them, which is quite cool. For the stairs, I went with these pine ones, as you can see, that kind of suit log cabins better, but of the available options, it was kind of the best one for this build that looked the least out of place, so that's what I went with. Not much on the roof, as really running out of decoration room by the time I got up here, but I did want to get the artillery piece on the roof, because it just felt kind of the most appropriate thing to put up here for a castle. I mean, the fact they'd probably shake the roof apart is a whole other matter, but anyway. And I put the Wasteland Gong up here just for kind of an alarm system in the event that our castle gets attacked. Just the ordinary wooden railings around the outside here. And as with the Blue Ridge build I did the other week, we've got them running around the edge of a staircase here, which they won't normally snap to. But fortunately, we have two staircases coming up to the top level. So you can take one out, replace it with floors, and then snap the railings onto the floors if you use the big floors. And then pull the floors back out once you've done that, and replace it with stairs, and you've got the railings around the stairs. And then just repeat on the other side, which is what I did here. A few more bits and pieces down here to decorate up the staircase. And I do like this. I'm not completely convinced about the mire as a location for this build, or the light, and if you're not too bothered about having it on water, you can kind of do it anywhere that there's a big enough flat area. And in some ways that might even be easier, you could kind of raise it up, though I'm not sure how that would look, to be honest. Little music area under the stairs there, just to occupy that space. A few extra bits of decoration in here. And we come back around to the main crafting room again. I do kind of like this place. It's fairly simple, but it works. And particularly like the little clusters of workbenches and stuff like that in here. It came together quite well. So I won't go so far as to call it cozy, but it's about as close as a castle's going to get. It's about as close to a castle as we're going to get in Fallout as well, I think. You could arguably go bigger, but you're going to struggle with decoration if you do that, so it is what it is. So, as we make our way across the bridge, you can sort of see on the right there, there's a bit of grass sticking up out of the water. We'll have a look when we spin back around. And it's this tiny little island that I mentioned at the start of the video. And the thing is literally a couple of meters of earth sticking up out of it. And my initial foundation was placed on there, and then I extended out into the water from it, sort of over to the right of the island, I should say. And I did it that way because to the left of the island, there's a sunken rowboat under the water that has absolutely no business being there because it interrupts your building and doesn't have any other function. So I had to shunt it over to the side a little bit. So if you can't place something under the water there, or it clips through the water, that's probably why. But yeah, we managed to work around it and come up with a full kind of castle build. It's a little bit square and I'd like the top edge to have maybe different levels to it and angles and stuff, but you got to work with what's available, and with the building pieces available in Fallout, it's not really geared towards building a castle, so this is a little attempt, but I'm quite happy with how the decoration and the internals in particular came out, and yeah, it's fun, it's something a bit different. So, I do hope you liked that one. If you did, please consider dropping subs and likes. I do very much appreciate it. Social media links, merch store and channel memberships down below the video as well. If you're interested in supporting the channel in that way, I very much appreciate it. It hugely helps out. And of course, you can catch us live streaming Fallout 76 from Wednesday onward with a new update. And of course, The Witcher as well, which I'm very much enjoying. So I do hope you join us for those. A lot of fun there. But for now, thank you very much for watching. And I look forward to speaking to you all very, very soon.